get really good, try popping a few wheelies.
Oh, they're going inside. Quick, save me a spot by the fire.
Gladly.
11-year-old Greg Macomber bypassed most of those steps, and he was popping wheelies when most of his friends were on training wheels. And come to think of it, I don't think Greg has even heard of training wheels.
It looks like a typical American scene. A boy and his bike riding along on a sunny day as his mind fantasizes he's the world's best rider, performing to a roaring crowd. But for little Greg Macomber, these dreams are reality. At the ripe old age of 11, Greg is one of the hottest BMX freestylers on a circuit full of battle-tested veterans. He's a hero, his daredevil stunts appearing in national magazines. A champion, performing on the Regis Philbin Show. A role model, inspiring others in how to ride videos.
Okay, I roll on the front peg, then kick the tire and roll around. And then I kick it some more and go around in circles. And then I try to stop it and ride away.
It all started with a trick. In front of his home in Whitensville, Massachusetts, when Greg was just 5, he did this. And it made his mother's heart skip a beat.
He loves it. He absolutely loves it. He loves that thrill. I should have known, I guess, when he was about 18 months old one day, he followed my husband up to the roof. He climbed a ladder at 18 months old. He loved the height and the thrill of it, and I was terrified when I saw his little white baby shoes climbing up this ladder. And ever since then, we should have known probably that he was going to find something in life to give him a thrill.
Getting thrills takes practice, practice, practice. 3 hours after school every day. In 1985, 86, and so far in 87, he's earned enough points to be the American Freestyle Association's top 13 and under expert in the Northeast. At today's competition in Warwick, Rhode Island, as the other riders are warming up for their routines, on the ground and in the air, Greg and his dad check their equipment and try to stay calm.
Well, this is the worst time right now, right before the competition. I get very, very jittery.
Even though there are champion riders from as far away as California, Florida, and Missouri in today's competition, there are just not enough serious challengers in Greg's age group or in the expert class. So you'll have to compete against older, stronger riders. Judges and veterans feel Greg can handle it.
Greg is exceptional. He has a certain kind of charisma and a professionalism that's developed. He's a veteran of probably 200 to 300 shows, performances, in the last 3 years.
It's like he's 19 years old like me. I can ride with him anytime I want to because of his aggressiveness is really aggressive. He wants to learn and he wants to be good.
A little nervous, but not that much. And I just watch everyone else and see how they do. I think about the order of my tricks in my routine and where I'm going to do each trick. Because sometimes I see one kid slip, so I know not to do a trick where I make a curve maybe, because then I might slip, so I do it somewhere else.
Finally, it's Greg's turn. His specialty is the intricate floor routine. A little support from Dad, and he's off. Greg's routine is good, but so are the others. Hot trick after trick with crazy names. Top rockers, fire hydrants, boomerangs, sliders, wheel runners, infinity rolls, squeakies. Can't name them all. In the end, Greg comes in third.
It was all right, but I could have done better.
But win or lose, for Greg, it's how he plays the game. And when he gets home, there's time off to take it easy and do the things that kids like to do. Because after all, inside that champion is still just a little boy at heart.
Well, Greg is just getting better and better. In fact, he won 4 first place in Ohio at the King of the Flatlands competition.
He also came in first with the American Association Freestyle Masters Championship.
Do you want eggnog?
Yes, I do.
You look like you're thirsty.
Quite a nice big cup here.